This morning, hundreds of Tara locals have been put on high alert, with conditions across the region expected to escalate.
Resident Sophie Bajor says that after weeks of living in fear, the days have all blurred into one. She joins us live now from Tara with the latest there. Good morning to you, Sophie, and thanks for your time. Tell us, how is everyone holding up in town at the moment?
Our community is resilient. We are strong and we're coming together to support everyone out there. The affected landowners are really worried about their property, and you know, it is just, it's devastating for everyone in town and out of town.
You know, what was your reaction and everyone else's reactions when you heard that conditions were set to flare up again?
It's absolutely heartbreaking. You think that these guys have been out there fighting so hard to protect houses and people and animals, and they are just faced with another day where conditions are worsening, and you don't know when it's going to let up. So it's heartbreaking.
Well, you're heading for temperatures in the mid-30s today, strong winds on the forecast as well. 46 homes have already been destroyed in Tara. Have you been in touch with any of those residents who've lost their properties, and what kind of support has been made available to them?
Yeah, Sylvia, I have. I have been talking to people who've lost their homes, and they were allowed back, I think, yesterday or the day before to go and assess the damage that has actually been done at their property. And I think it's just really sunk in for them. But they're strong. They will come through this. On the other side, there's a lot of support given from local businesses. We're starting to get outside support now for these affected people. So I think we're going to be okay. And these guys just need to start the healing process now.
Yeah, but you, Sophie, have been very vocal about wanting to get Tara to establish a refuge centre. What's happening with that? Has the council or local businesses there come to the table on this?
Well, what we've got is we've got a local meeting today at 11. Mm-hmm. So we're hoping that we'll get some news there. Because we've still got some people living in cars around town that have been evacuated in the last 24 hours. And, you know, not everyone can make it to the evacuation centre in Dalby or Chinchilla. Mm. So we're just asking for somewhere where these people can go to have a safe night rather than sleeping in their vehicles.
So you're saying there's currently no evacuation centre set up in Tara itself?
No, the evacuation centre was set up in Tara, and then it was relocated to Dalby and Chinchilla when the fire came close to the town boundary a few days ago.
Which is what, at least an hour away from Tara itself, Dalby?
Yes, yeah. Dalby is. Chinchilla is also, but you know, we've got the Tara-Chinchilla Road, which is closed due to the events that are going on out there.
Well, that meeting is at 11 o'clock this morning, Sophie, so good luck with that. Let us know how you go, and please give our love and the nation's love to everyone there at the moment. We hope that conditions ease today.
Stay safe.
Thank you very much.
Two states are in the grips of wild weather, with Queensland bracing for an horrific day of bushfires and New South Wales lashed by cyclonic winds. Our reporting team is across the developments this morning. We'll start with Olivano Lathouris, who is live for us in Tara. Ollie, good morning. Crews are warning of horrific conditions to continue today.
Davina, today is the day that the community of Tara have been bracing for. Even as we've been standing here this morning, the winds are really picking up. It's going to be a hot day, low humidity, just nightmarish conditions for fire crews. Yesterday was supposed to be an opportunity for fire and emergency services to get a bit of a handle on this blaze before the fire conditions today. But even with weather on our side, there were flare-ups. The area that I'm standing in this morning, forced to evacuate, leave their homes at a moment's notice when a fire started ripping through bushland. We spoke to one terrified resident yesterday. Here's what she had to say.
We were sort of watching it, and then I had a look out, and it was just right there covering the sun. Couldn't see anything, dark as anything, and I've got two small girls and dogs and everything, so I just packed the car and got out because it's just too close to home.
Yeah. How have the last couple of days been for you?
Full on, to say the least.
A Watch and Act warning remains in place for the community of Tara, but emergency services have told us this morning that by midday they are expecting the situation to seriously have escalated. 46 homes have already been lost in this disaster. Two lives have tragically also been lost, and emergency services are going to be doing absolutely everything in their power to make sure that those numbers don't rise any higher today.